Now that you've received Jesus Christ, one of the first things you ought to do is tell somebody else that you got saved. Darrell Robinson, who wrote the book Total Church Life, used to take his new converts soul winning with him as soon as the next day after they got saved. He took them to see their old friends so that they could tell them that they had gotten saved. Of course, he grew some very large churches as a result, and he also grew some very strong Christians. Now, the pattern of witnessing is something that we find in the Bible, and it's a pattern of witnessing to others right after our salvation. And so, you know what? We're going to look in the Bible and look at some of these cases. For instance, when Jesus was witnessing to the woman at the well in John chapter 4, she believed that he was the Messiah. And as soon as she believed that, she left her water pot in verse 28, headed for the city where she told the men, "Come see a man which told me all things that ever I did. Is not this the Christ?" The result of her testimony was that many of the Samaritans of that city believed on him for the saying of the woman which testified, "He told me all that ever I did." Notice, she testified of the truth of what Jesus Christ had done for her. She told what she knew, and that's what a witness does. In Acts chapter 3, when Peter and John healed the lame man in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, he let people know right away what had happened to him. The Bible says he, leaping, stood up and walked and entered with them into the temple, walking and leaping and praising God. He was unashamed to publicly praise the Lord for healing him. And of course, his public display and testimony caused them that were there to be filled with wonder and amazement at that which had happened unto him. There's another case in Mark chapter 7. Here, Jesus Christ healed a deaf man with a speech impediment. He charged him and the men that brought him to Jesus that they should tell no man. You know what? Jesus specifically told them, keep quiet about this miracle. They were given a command not to say anything. And yet, in spite of Jesus' charge, the more he charged them, so much the more a great deal they published it. Most of us are looking for an excuse to keep from having to witness to people, not these folks. They had more than excuse. They had a command from the Lord, and yet they were testifying. That's what we're supposed to do. There's another case of this in Matthew chapter 9. You'll see exactly the same thing. All right, we have another lesson to learn. This one is from John chapter 9. This is the blind man that was healed. He was cornered by his neighbors who wanted to know exactly what happened to him because they knew he was the blind man, and now they knew he could see, and they wanted to know how it happened and who did it. You know what's going to happen to you when you get saved? You're going to have some neighbors that are going to want to know what happened to you, why you're starting to go to church, why you're reading your Bible, why you've changed. Well, look at the answer that came in verse 11. He tells it just like it happened. He gave a perfect testimony. This is what he said. A man that is called Jesus, you find that in verse 3, made clay, you find that in verse 6, and anointed mine eyes, you find that in verse 6, and said unto me, go to the pool of Siloam, that's in verse 7, and wash, that's in verse 7, and I went, that's in verse 7, and washed, that's in verse 7, and I received sight. You know what? He gave a perfect testimony of every detail of what Jesus had done for him. When you witness to people, just tell them exactly what Jesus Christ did for you. Let's look at another case. In the Gadarenes, one of the wickedest men in the whole country got saved, and when he did, his conversion caused quite a stir. He had so many devils in him that when Jesus Christ cast them out, 2,000 swine were drowned in the sea. Well, needless to say, Jesus wasn't welcome to stay in that region. So when he got ready to leave, the formerly demon-possessed man wanted to go with him. But you know what Jesus told him? Jesus told him to stick around and tell the folks how great things the Lord hath done for thee and hath had compassion on thee. So he did what he was told to do. And you know what the results were? He departed and began to publish in Decapolis how great things Jesus had done for him, and all men did marvel. That's what we need to do. We need to tell them about the great things that Jesus Christ has done for us. Let's look at one more example. And this time we'll look at an example of Saul. That's Paul, the one who wrote the New Testament books that we call epistles. When he got saved in Acts chapter 9, he had a good reason to fear telling others about Jesus Christ because he'd been making havoc of the church and persecuting the church. Nevertheless, within just a few days of getting saved, he preached Christ in the synagogues that he is the Son of God. So you know what? We don't have an excuse. You need to tell as many folks as you know about the Son of God and what He's done for you. Remember, a witness is not responsible for the decision that others make based on his testimony. What they decide to do with what they learn from your testimony is strictly up to them. Your job is to tell them who saved you, how He saved you, and what He's done for you since you've gotten saved. Then you can end your testimony by encouraging them that Jesus Christ will save them too. Now, I'm going to give you a good idea. It's a real good idea for you to carry gospel tracts with you when you go that clearly present the gospel so that you can leave them with interested listeners. You ought to also have a pocket New Testament. I've got a couple of examples right here. Carry these with you so that you can mark them and memorize verses that are dealing with salvation. That way you can show a person from the Bible what the Bible says about how to be saved. Now, we have Bibles here and we have tracts here for you that are very suitable for this work. And if you think you might need some, contact us and we'll help get you a supply. May God bless you as you go about now to witness to your family and to your friends and your neighbors what great things Jesus Christ has done for you. And may God bless you when you do.